Okay, Joshua can start.
哎，Hello，大家好，都听得到吗？
听得到，听得到。
听得到，好，
听得
好的，
到。
都吃饱了哈，很好很好好嘞，那同样的，今天我也是要用中文跟英文来跟大家分享，今天要分享的就是 Google Map。Okay, today I'm going to share about Google Map. First, I will use Mandarin, then followed by English. So in between, I'll use my handphone to do a demonstration on how to use it. 好，那我就是说，刚才我有说了，就是我用先用英华语，然后再用英语来跟大家分享。同样的，我也会用那个手机来。的那个应用程序给大家示范一下那个我们的这个那个谷歌地图 Google Map 的一些简单的用法，好吗？好，大家都准备好了
好，
啊？OK，好，我来分享我的桌面。好的，这个桌面呢就在这里。那我先把这个给放小一点，好，今天要分享的就是这个我们叫做 Google Map 啊，谷歌地图，大家都有用过吗？
没有，
啊，没有啊，
我没有用。
没有用，那可以通过今天的那个学习之
天
后
气。
呢，你就可以用啊，不清楚
啊。
啊，Uncle Lim，你也可以过来我们这边啊。
嗯。
哦，这边学习好，今天要学习的就是谷歌地图，英文叫做 Google Map 啊。其实地图那个谷歌地图是最常用了，在我们这一代最常用。如果你是用你是用那个Samsung 的，通常都是它都会好像都是原先安装给我们看啊。所以今天要学的就是我们怎么样去，用这个谷歌地图来找我们要去的一个地方啊。而且它会一步一步的带领我们好像你要搭车啊，你要坐车啊，你要走路啊，或者是到一些有趣的地方啊，这些都在 Google Map 里面，它谷歌地图里面都有的。然后。同样的，怎么样安装呢？就是要看你的手机啦，苹果手机当然是用那个 Apple Store，然后安卓就是 Play Store，我这里就没有放那个华为手机，也是一样的，华为就是华为商店华为商店。那你在安装的时候呢，你要看到这下面这个标志这个标志就是叫做 Google Map。好，来，接下来，那谷歌地图啊，Google Map 它是一个怎么样的一个东西啊？其实它是一个功能很广的一个软件，一个应用程序。通常在以前啊，我们没有这个导航系统的时候，我要去马来西亚，刚开始我要有一个人带我去，然后。在路上呢，我就死背着整个行程，应该要看到什么标志，要怎么样走的那种，哇，很辛苦。以前没有南北大道嘛，也那个路呢也是不是很好走，而且很多车，常常走丢了。然后你都没有你没有一个导航系统的话，你就是跟着前面的车走啊。如果你是一般一群人去的话。那是一个很有挑战的一个事情，但是自从有了这个导航系统那就很轻松了。你不管你去到什么地方，你都不用担心，就是有这个软件帮助我们。然后我要跟大家说明一点的，就是这个谷歌地图，你去到中国是没有办法使用的。 对啊，你别说哦，我要去中国，我可以用这个谷歌地图，但是在，对不起，中国这是用不了。所以我在中国的时候，我是用用有一个叫做高什么呢？我一时忘记了，因为我已经没有把它装在里面。高好像是高凯地图啊，还有很多很多中国的其他的一些导航系统，那些都在中国里面就很好用啊，很好用，但是这个谷歌地图在香港是可以用的哦，在台湾、香港都可以用。谷歌地图它有两种，一种就是用在手机，另外一种是在电脑。如果你跟你的手机跟电脑是联系的话呢，当你在电脑上查那个地方的时候，你的手机也有这样的一个历史，所以很方便的，很容易的就连接上，它的一些功能呢，就是你可以计划你的行程。你不要说哦，我没有去过那个地方啊，我不知道花多少时间去啊，所以我迟到。在今天这种是不是一个很好的借口啊？因为现在可以通过一些软件啊，就是谷歌地图的话，它可以告诉我们什么时段是高峰时期，什么时段我们应该花多少时间。然后安排我们的行程，还有呢，好处就是我要从一个地方 A 到 B，是走哪一条线比较好？我要搭地铁，搭那个巴士车，还是要坐那个我们的出租车啊、德士啊？哪一个方法最快？那哪条路最短？哪一条路不堵车？它这个谷歌地图呢，它一一的可以跟我们。呈现出来，然后我们可以选我们可以选说，哦，我现在要走哪条路啊？那如果你即使是你没有那个我们叫做没有网络啊，你也可以用下载，然后用来也是可以用的哦，所以是很方便的。好，我现在给大家看一些它的应用那个画面。第一页我们所看到，在我左边这里啊，就是谷歌的主页。你打开的时候呢，你会看到这一页，这一页就告诉你你的目前的所在地啊。尤其是你按这里的时候，按这里的时候，它就是锁定你的那个地方。然后下面也有一些其他的那个按钮啊，你看哦，第一个就是 Explore，当你按下去的时候呢。你会看到，你周围的一些地方，就好像我家附近啊，就是这个红帽桥的一个那个花园。这个花园呢，就其实是在那个红帽桥的那个地铁站的对面啊，那个应该是有很多人去了拍拖最多了，周末很多人拍拖，你在地铁站那里就可以看到。上面有很多人，那当然第二个呢，你按了这个 explore 的人呢，就是第二个就是这个 go，你们看到吗？就是你去过的地方，你按一下，它会把你过去去过的地方都呈现出来，就好像上回我来到这里，我们的 Block 5或者是 Bukit Merah Interchange。Bukit Merah Central 什么地方它都有个记录都在记录在里面。然后你过去再看一下我们这个叫做什么？我看清楚save。save 就是你储存的一些地方，就是你要常常用的，就好像你的住家啦、你的工作地点啦，或者是你的亲戚好友的家，都可以把它记录在里面。然后你要去的时候，你不必说。哎呀，他住在哪里？然后我要整天去找他。你地址全部都给你记录在里面，那是非常方便的好，再看下去它的功能是什么？我们再看。另外一个功能其实很多人不知道，其实这个谷歌地图它把我们所去的地方都保留下来。虽然我刚才说。谷歌地图在中国是用不上，但是你所到的地方，只要你的手机开着，它能够记录下来。所以你看我这个，我现在 你看到、啊、我过去，那个是在还没有那个有冠病之前呐、啊，所以在2019年的时候，我还是到处跑的时候，你会看到这就是一个记录哈。你会看到我去的地方啊，从北到南，从北就是哈尔滨啊、沈阳啊、西安啊，然后就在哪里啊？武汉啊，我也去过武汉，台北啊，广州啊，然后就下到去到马来西亚啦，去到印度尼西亚。你去到的地方，它全部都给你记录下来。你去过的城市，你在这个城市待多久，去这个城市多少个地方，它都给你记录。就好像说，在新加坡不用说了哈，我当然是我们天天在这里生活。然后好像说，2年前我去上海，去了24个地方，在上海那边跑，然后这个什么嘉兴4个地方啊，嘉兴是在上海的南方。一个工厂的一个地方，嘉兴，然后深圳，然后就东莞，我在东莞，然后在福州啊，对你去过的城市都会记录下来，然后另外一个是你去过的国家，它也会记录下来，就好像我去，我也去过，我也是去3年前去印度、去印度尼西亚、去马来西亚、去澳门这些地方，你去过哪里，他都能够把你记录下来，所以也你不要说啊，我把手机关掉就可以。其实，即使是你把手机关掉，他也能够捕捉到你的足迹。啊，这个是我也有做过一个记录啊，一个试验呐、啊，就是把我的那个定点关掉，但是他还是能够记录下来，这个是很厉害的。不为人所知的一个功能在里面，你可以说是好，也是可以说不好了，但是要看我们怎么样用法。好，那下来我们是看我是如何利用谷歌地图来给我做导航，好像我要去从一个地方到另外一个地方，我应该怎么做？第一步呢，就是你打开首页的时候，所以我在我的左手边就是一个首页。首页的时候你就看到上面这里吗？他说你可以打一些输入一些字，比如说加油站啊，或者是什么购物中心啊，或者是 ATM 啊，你就是取钱的那个提款机啊，只要你把那个地址打进去，它就能够出来。好，那怎么样输入呢？我们这里可以有三个方法。第一个呢，就是输入街名，就好像说我第一个我输入依顺第51道，然后我只要点入那个51道的时候，它就会出来。另外一个呢，就是输入你的邮区，比方说我们这里是09000055大牌5号码哈，那你只要你打进去，它就能够把那个地方给呈现出来。另外一个呢，就是你可以把那个建筑物的名字建筑物的名称，你可以打 Vivo City， 或者你是说 Ion， 或者是你是打樟宜 Airport， 啊，樟宜机场，只要你输进去，它就能够出来，然后它就显示出来，然后我们就可以选说哪一个是我要去的一个地方啊。好，那除了这一个呢之外呢，我们接下来看、哦、就是说当我选到那个地方的时候，比方说我是选 Vivo City， 就是我们的滨海、那个叫做什么滨海湾，对，滨海湾，滨海湾的时候呢，我就点击第三点，就是方向。然后点击方向的时候，它会出现另外一页，就是你要从哪一个地方出发、哦、你的出发地点。所以你把你的，你可以选择是某一个地方出发呢，或者是你现在的所在地出发。然后接下来呢，你可以看这一个哈、哦，这个你看到了哦。这个有没有看到一个7分钟啊？这辆车啊，
坐的士，
你开车的话，你坐 taxi 的话，只要是汽车，就是七分钟。如果你驾摩托车，六分钟。
六分钟。
嗯，搭车十三分钟，然后走路哦也可以。
哇！
啊，这个七分钟啊，那个手招出来就是我们的，其实我们这里就不流行啊，我们没有，你招手没有人会让你停车载你的啊。哦、这个美国才有，不过他的意思也是说你招车就好像你叫车一样哦。嗯，然后呢，这个接下来你会看到 depart， 这个就是你几点。你几点想出发，你也可以选择现在出发。比方说我想知道四点出发，像我这里四点出发的时候大概多少时间会抵达那个地方。这个主要的功能就是帮助我们能够安排我们的行程啊。好，你也可以说我明天或者后天某一个时段我也可以。啊，它是通过一系列的过去路况的一些记录来计算大概是多少。但是我呢，就是我有开车，那我开车的时候很准的，不管你除非你开得特别快。通常我的开车速度我现在是比较慢一点的，大概是80-90的，以前我年轻一点的开车特别快。哦，开车特别快，浪费汽油。但是不管你开得快还是开得慢，你抵达的那个时间差不了多少，几分钟，最多给你快也快不了那个5分钟、10分钟啊。所以为了安全起见呢，我们最好是提前进入，提前出发。嗯，不，那如果是说从这里呢，我们可以看到。如他有一个就是叫我们说最好选择是哪一个，好像这个你要搭143，然后再转30，再转10号，哦，这个三趟巴士大概也是13分钟，或者你可以搭188，从你的地点出发要13分钟，这个是一个给你一个选项啊。来，我们接下来看。当你就是把你的那个你所在的地点你所在的地点还有你要去的一个地方，你看到这里它可以兑换，就是说我可以从如果我的兑换就是我从 Vivo City 到我刚来原来的地方是多少，它也能够这样的一个兑换来做出发点和那个目的地的。然后第五这里呢，你会看到就是我们有不同的选项，你如果要搭一趟车的不要转车的大概是花多少时间，或者是你要搭地铁再坐车再坐走路大概也是会花多少时间，都有，这些都有啊。他会帮我们显示说多少时间在里面，然后给我们更多的时间来预备啊。好，目前还 OK 吗？大家没问题吧？
还 OK，
没问题 OK 啊，好。因为这个是一个很简单的一个软件，一个很简单应用程序，所以最好等一下我就会给大家看一下，我接上手机的时候就容易看。好，然后呢，当你好像我选的刚才是选这里呢，我是选970再加上一个65。要20分钟，那我的出发地点是在 Great World City。Great World City 的大世界啊。
对。
新深入那个大世界啊，大世界那出发，然后就到我们的那个滨海湾了。滨海湾就是我们的 Vivo City。然后在路上他会告诉你，好像我在金深入这边啊，金深入要走大概是70米啊。到我那个车站，就是他会跟你讲是说在大世界对面的车站啊，这里是英文啊，所以我们要学习一下怎么样去看啊。或者你可以看到那个他也会 你拿起来的时候，你走路，它也可以带领我们怎么样走的。
这个就是它的那个导航的，就是说它走到哪个车站，它应该有一个记号吧？
对对，它有几个功能，一个是用那个相机来拍，你可以拿起来，然后就好像这样拍路这样的时候，它会说向左，它会带领我们向左转、向右转，这个也是其中的一个功能。或者是你不要用相机的话，它有本身就有那个导航的跟 GPS
导航的系统啊，
对，它也能够知道我们现在 的那个我们的所在地点在哪里。如果我们走偏了，它也会跟人说哦，我们要掉头。所以这个是很好的，尤其是当我们在国外的时候好像我的孩子上次他去日本嘛，但是也是还没有官兵之前他去日本旅行，他就说哎呀日语他又不懂，然后他就用这个 Google 啦，Google 很方便，然后他就用另外一个软件，这个翻译软件只要他讲英语他就能跟他讲日语出来，然后他说哇这个真的是太好了又能够带领我去，又路上又介绍我哪里好吃的地方有什么东西看。所以这个谷歌软件是很怎么样，很好用。好，那我目前就介绍到这里，我现在是要用我的手机来跟模拟给大家看。好
OK
啊，来我先停止分享，然后再介绍我的手机。好的，用我的
老师。
哎，来
啊，请问刚才你说有好也不有不好，就是说他会一直记录你的行踪是吗？
对的，对的，对的，对的。
你是要 switch on turn on 那个 location， 他才会跟踪。
其实啊，我是试过啊，我这个 location 就是你看到手机。这里吗？有没有看到 location？ 看到哈。如果我把它关掉他说我关掉，他会告诉我你这个 location 是关掉了。但是呢，我看过一个 YouTube 他就有这个视频，他自己本身也做了一个试验，就是说，即使你把它关掉，它也能够捕捉到你去过的地方。所以。
他是警察啦，
不是警察。
你说的他是哪一个他？
没有，就是说 YouTuber， 他就是一个做 YouTube 的一个人，他做了一个这样的一个试验，他说我有谷歌地图，然后我就把我的定点关掉，看我去的地方到底能不能够被记录下来。结果答案是没有全部被记录，但是能够捕捉到他去到哪一个角落的一些信息都可以看得到。
他是私家侦探啊，
私家侦探。
他有追踪器，
他是间谍。
他是间谍，但是我们不用担心啊，我们是普通老百姓哦。当然
也没有什么东西给他抓了。
他要做什么都没有什么东西好做。
坏人要跟踪。
对
对
对
对,
对,
对。
只有他们的心不正的时候他们在担心。我们是光明正大的。好，来我们先，你先看到我的屏幕了哦。
有
啊，我手机屏幕，那你我就把它拉上来的时候你会看到它。你看到一个地方Mount Faber Park 对，就是说如果你想去这个地方的时候呢，你就点击下去，它就带领我们去这个地方你点击对吗？你看我点击的
那个红点
就是那个 Mount Faber 就带出来了，然后我再退回那个好吃的
哇
这个好吃的在哪里我不知道这个 Hawker Store 在哪里啊，也是在附近然后你就会看得到了周家周家下面你有没有看到他的那个
住家
卖粥的，真多粥少那个粥你看到下面的图片吗？我在转下面 有啊，就是那个地方。 然后如果你不要你 退回的时候你还可以看到很多的、哦、这个是 Safra 的游泳池、哦、相当漂亮、哦啊、拉丁马斯、哦、这个大家很熟悉的一个地方、哦嗯、然后这里是不知道在哪里 Terrace Garden 我不知道在哪里，所以、啊、就是这个他就、给我们
以前叫 Alcove Mansion、不知道还在不在、
啊、不知道
有 Alcove Mansion 还有
嗯
啊、那个地方就是、
有、
嗯、应该是啦、哦、我不大清楚
因为有
时
候电影还在
啊什么
阿卡门身上面有人拍 有人拍、
哦、有人拍、啊、好接下来我们来看的就是这个 Go 我点一下的时候你会看到 Go 然后它就会跟着 你住的什么地方你的工作地点你常去的地点在哪里它都都有一个建议啦其实、
嗯、
建议去过的地方然后这个是你储存的一些地方、啊、你去过的地方都有、啊、都有在里面、啊、你会看到上面吗 Explore Timeline 的这里有没有看到
有、
啊、这里好像刚才我跟大家分享的就是我、以前去过的地方、啊、你看
哦、
有没有啊、哦？你看、啊
哦、全部红色的、哦
哦、红色的就是你去过的，
就是你去过的。
啊，你打开的时候，好像我去
台
湾，
台北，
我在台湾三义，三义啊，
武林，
武林啊，那个什么，福西，台南啊，这个我去过的。
厦门，
啊，我去香港。
在中国、
啊、这个我去东莞我去
深
圳啦、
啊、
香港啦、
啊、来 Hong Kong 了、
啊、对九龙啦、哦
嗯、
不管你去哪里它都能够捕捉得到啦虽然是谷歌地图、哦、它、看不到、我们在那边用不上但是还可以、哦、我也去过武汉武汉我去过几次、嘉兴、上海然后我再上去我上次是去了哪里啊？沈阳、哦
嗯、
我去哈尔滨很冷很冷的地方黑龙江、
哦、黑龙江
对 对这些只要你去过的地方它能够显示出来
嗯
、啊、然后它会告诉你你、哦、这个是今天你走什么你可以从这个时间上面呢你去呢好像你可以找回你要去的你去过的地方好像说2019年5月的时候我在哪里啊他都有记录哦你是坐公共汽车你在坐飞机然后你去购物啊你在住酒店住了多久你看全部的东西都在里面很详细很详细
太详细了真的跑不掉
对啊跑不掉那不用怕不用怕我们没有做坏事不用怕的啊啊、还有呢另外一个就是介绍我们的什么好吃的东西、
oh.
好玩的地方多少个城市多少个国家、
oh.
而喜欢出国的人就很好然后呢、
oh.
嗯好的那我们赶快就回来到怎么样应用哈、oh. 怎么样应用好刚才你就看到这个是世界然后你看到这一边这边、哦、有一个白白的你点下去它就会来到新加坡这里啊，
okay.
就点一下就到我们这里、
嗯。
然后如果我要去什么地方，我就在这个 search here 上面这里，我点下去，好像说我要去红山，我点红山的时候呢，啊，他就告诉我红山是在哪里 ，Bukit Merah 怎么样去，然后我点这个方向
direction。
他就如果说我开车是四分钟骑摩托三分钟、
嗯、
我这个就要搭车
那
条蓝色的路搭车的话呢就是、我们要走这个272、
嗯、
12分钟如果是说我们搭145再转176也要12分钟、
嗯、
然后这个方式方法
老师那个不是说搭145转176他的意思是说可以搭145、
哦、对对对
你可以搭145或者是搭176
对对对对对对
对他不可能
转到来这样短这样附近的地方 OK、
不是转车不是转车、
OK 好
啊，对不起啊，
不要紧，不要紧。
啊，好像说我大272，然后272呢，是从你的个地方走十分钟，走一分钟，
嗯，
啊，然后就去那个大牌11号的车站，
嗯，
他还告诉你现在车，会不会多人？你看一个 line not crowded， 有没有看到这个？嗯
，line，OK，、
okay. 啊，对不起，
那
他就说现在是
not crowded，
对，
不拥挤
啊，然后你就坐两个站，然后再走6分钟就到了那个红山，
到中心，
就是这样，很简单的。
哦 ，OK。
好，我们那个你可以自己学习啦，哦。
嗯。
嗯。好，你现在有没有问题啊？来学习。
So far OK。
OK 了哈。
嗯
，OK。
我先喝口水一下。
我问你啊。
啊，好。
我先啊。老师啊。
哎、hey, ，来。
I want to go to Queen Street Hotel. How to go?
Queen Street 啊。
Queen Street Hotel.
Queen Street Hotel. 等一下，我没有听清楚哈。
在 Chinatown。
Chinatown 啊。
哎。
如果你能够打那个酒店的名字，
那个他有讲 building 就可以了，是吗？
啊，对啊，你也可以用手用
讲话的。打那个 building 进去就可以，是吗？
好像我现在打开哦， oh. 如果我是用讲话的哈， oh. 有没有看到？
有，
可以用讲话。Queen's， 你是说 Queen Street Hotel 是什么？
是 Queen Street Hotel， 在 Queen Street。
不是，它的名字就是叫 Queen Street Hotel， 它 hotel 的名字是 Queen Street 啊。
哦，好，我试一下啊。
哎，哦 ，OK。
来试一下 ，Queen Street Hotel， 有没有？
有了
啊。然后现在呢？
哦，
就是、
那个 Carlton 好像叫 Queen Street Hotel， 是叫 Carlton Hotel。
哦 ，Carlton Hotel。
啊 ，Carlton Hotel， 对。
哎，他跟我讲 Queen Street Hotel 嘞、嗯，
这样不是 Queen Street 啦，他可能在那边附近
啦。
哦。
啊。哦。真正的他 hotel 的名字是这个。
如果我再讲一下哈，我们再找一个啊。Vivo City 啊，对吗？哦，有了哈、
啊，出来了 ，Vivo City，
出来了
yes,
然后我就按下方向。
对对对，因为 Vivo City 是一个 building 来的嘛。
啊，对，一个 building 来的。然后如果说要不然我就现在要出国了哈，我们去搭飞机呀，
搭
飞机了，我们去Terminal One。
哦，樟宜 Airport。
还有吗？还没有。可以吗？啊，对呀、啊、，Terminal One， 樟宜。
哎，你讲 Terminal One， 你不要讲樟宜 Airport， 它都可以出来的
啊。它也可以的，这个是在新加坡，所以它能够很方便。
Oh, okay.
好像我再讲多一次 Terminal Four， 看怎样。
OK。
Terminal Four。
哎，你这个
啊，
讲话的功能刚才在哪里找到啊？
哦、啊，对不起，这个讲话的就在上面。等一下
啊。哪里啊？
那我再退出去。
这个，
你看到上面吗？我这个打字这里，有没有一个在我的在左右上角？
右上角
啊，在上面，在上面，
哦、
那个 battery 那边，你看到现在有 Bukit Merah 吗？
有看到
Bukit Merah Center 一个打叉、
哦、，OK 啊，
打叉旁边那
个，打叉，然后一个麦，
它边边的那个麦哈、啊，
对、
哦、okay,
你点那个麦的时候，你就能够直接跟他说，
哦、okay, 好，看到了，OK，
我还没有试过你用地址啊，就邮区啦，哈、
哦，邮区很大嘞、
啊，
那个地区。
我不大清楚能不能够啦，好、
哦，
然后我们来试一下，你们有什么邮区可以建议吗？
就好像刚才你啊
哪个邮
区？
没有邮区，你要讲号码嘞。
Postcode 讲号码。
Postcode 啦，邮区号码。
有没有一个？
不会啊。
Bukit Purmai 是多少啊 ？Bukit Purmai。
Bukit Purmai 是
06 8828。
06
090107。
零九零幺零七。
哦，等一下我去找你啊。
啊，
等一
下啊。
可以。
没有，看看可以不可以找。
09107。
哎呦，我还找得到我。
有没有？
等一下啊。
找得到吗？等一下，再来试一下。
没有没有，他是。
09101107。可能这个就是，
可能这个太
对，这比较困难一点。如果我们直接打讲地址的话，就就容易。好像我说，
明明可能要
老巴萨，老巴萨，
老巴萨。
哦，那个我们发音要很准啊，如果不准的话就不可以了。
是的。
好，好，就这样，很简单的，我们可以用自己的那个方式。可以输入，可以用邮区，可以用建筑的名称，或者是用讲话的方式。不过要看你手机是以中文还是英文的那个设置。如果你中文的就可能就用中文的。好，
teacher, what about this Malaysia Kampung area? Can find out those Kampung area?
Malaysia can.
Kampung, those Kampung, village.
Kampung, Kampung 应该是可
以。 But you must give.
Give the full detail address.
What about Johor? What Johor?
Johor can work.
See whether can work.
Can work. Then you go Johor.
But say Johor Bahru.
I mean, town area can find lah. But then, 如果甘榜怎么办？
Yeah lah, because you must say you must give Johor.
我去那个，我去那个 Bukit, 那个叫什么？有那个一时讲不起。Batu Pahat.我去巴都巴哈的时候，我就你看我直接的打进去，巴都巴哈。哦，这个巴都巴哈呢？对呀，他就带我去了。然后我就巴都巴哈，我是开车去的，然后他就会到处，你看到了吗？两个钟头就到巴都巴哈了。
两个钟头22分。
所以他很厉害的，很厉害的哈。
Mr. Cole, are you going to start from scratch in English? Huh? You haven't started English?
Yes. 好了吗？好了，我可以用中文了。我用英文了，三点。Okay, shall we back? 我们来，我用英文的跟大家分享。
You must speak solely in English. Don't half Mandarin, half Chinese. English are very hard to understand. I don't understand Mandarin.
You don't understand Mandarin. Okay, no problem.Okay, let me stop sharing. Sorry, how many? I think it's okay. All right. Okay, now, by now, I'm going to use English to share about today. Oh, sorry. Let me share my screen. Okay, you should be able to see my screen now, right?All right. Can you see? Can you see my screen? Okay. All right. So today I'm going to share with you about Google Map. How are you going to use it? How Google Map can help us to find the place?
Google Map, see the place.
Use Google Map to plan our journey and how to find or how to explore more by using Google Map. Okay.So, of course, we are using different methods. Like, for example, Apple Store is using iPhone, and then Play Store using Android. Or Huawei Shop is using Huawei. So for Huawei, there are some challenging parts. So if you do not know how to use Huawei to install, you are using Huawei phone, then you may have to do some setting.But no problem, if you come to us, we can help you on how to install Google Map. The reason partly also because Google has stopped serving Huawei. That's why you find challenge. But I also noticed that for those people who came from China, their China map in Singapore is still able to work. It's only things that it can't display some of our local street because it's in English.So they might find it very difficult for them to travel if they don't understand don't really understand English that well, because our, you know, in Singapore, our street can be in, although it's written in English, but it can be a Chinese name, can be a Malay name, can be a Hindu name, a Tamil name, I mean, a Tamil name. So there are many versions of the root name, very unique in Singapore. All right, so as we move on, Google Map is actually a very powerful tool that help us to find our way, help us to go to another place or to discover what is interesting, can be food, can be scenery, can be anything. You can use Google Map to help us to locate it. There is two major versions, whether we can use a PC or we can use iPhone. I mean the phone, doesn't mean iPhone. But once you link your computer and your phone together, whatever you search on your phone, it will also appear on your computer, on the history. Because the two history, the two versions of the map are linked together, so it's only one. The main function is to help us to plan our journey so that we'll not be late. So, and also to find the shortest way, the fastest way to go to the destination that we want. There is also setting inside, like whether you want to turn on the sound guide you, turn left, turn right, or just want to keep silent. And also how to go to a place in the very shortest time or shorter way, whether you want to go by a highway or not highway, or a lot of settings that can help you to do it.
Sorry, Mr. Koh, isn't this the same as GPS when you drive?
Yeah, this is a GPS.
GPS, same or not?
Yeah, of course. Without GPS, you are not able to use this Google Map.
Oh, okay.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so you can also download the map if you want, offline. It's very useful if you go to overseas. Like you travel to Germany and I do not know the city well, I may not have access to the GPS, but the data I try to minimize, then you can pre-download the map, then it will help you, and it's faster because you have a offline map, it's very fast. Okay, so on the first page of our Google Map is called home page. When you're in home page, there are many buttons at the bottom, there's about five of them. So I just pick the most common one that I show you. For example, the first one is explore. Explore means they will detect where you are and they will show you what are the interesting places around you, right? So if you are, for example, we are now in Radimas area, it will show us the nearest place of interest will be Mount Faber, or maybe the best food around here could be in Red Hill Market, that kind of things. Okay, so this is under explore. The other one, the other button that you can see is a go, the sign of a bus and a car, that kind of thing. Go means where are the places that you have been to? Okay, within a very short period, maybe you keep for about 20 data. In fact, I don't think it limit it, it will keep tracking wherever you go, you help you to, you don't have to key in, like, for example, you went last week, and this week you need to go again. So you don't have to key in, oh, I forgot the address, but you can just go to the history, like you type on go, and then it will come up for you. So this will save you a lot of time.
Sorry, can I interrupt, Mr. Koh? No, you said you put explore, but if you don't identify your location, how do the Google Map know where are you?
Wherever you've been to, they will track.
I just put explore, they know where is my exact location I'm now in.
Yes.
Okay,
yes.
No need to identify where am I now, no need.
You remember, you see this logo on the first page. Can you see this sign?
Uh-huh.
On the screen. This is the one that when you touch on it, it will show you where you are.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. So you can also send address. You know, you WhatsApp, there's this function called send address.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, you go to WhatsApp and then there's a paper clip. You select paper clip. You say you, then you will appear, right? Whether you want to share, you want to put in the picture, you want to put in name card, you want to put in the location. So if you click the location button in the WhatsApp, it will show Google Map where you are exactly.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. So this will help you to know where you are. You know, sometimes like we go to a place, you tell your friend, I'm here, I'm here, I'm here. But they don't know where you are, you know. Mm-hmm. You say, I'm here, also no use. But if you go to Google WhatsApp, you send to your friend your location, straight away they can use Google Map to trace up to you.
Sorry, excuse me, Mr. Koh. Just now you said download and then you can do it offline, yeah? But in outside, you still have to use our mobile data, right?
If you travel overseas, okay. The reason why download is fast because they don't have to download the file again, especially when you're overseas. So if we have the map in our handphone, the system will just track the GPS and our phone and then straight away point to us the location. But because we are in Singapore, we normally don't download the map because it's very fast and also we are using our own plan. But if you go overseas, you are on roaming mode. Roaming, you are worried that your data is very high. If you have to keep, track the system. When you walk, you track, and then you update the file, update the map. This will use up a lot of data, especially when you're overseas. But in Singapore, you won't, because this is our local country.
Oh, okay? So in Singapore, you don't need to use our mobile data, but overseas?
No, it's not. It still need mobile data, but I mean the map. The map itself, the Singapore map, like on the left hand side, the map. You don't have to download the map.
Okay, understand.
So the other one is if you click this, means you can pre-record the location that you want to go, like star, label, favorite, you know, that kind of thing. Yeah. Yeah, these are hardly used. Even I myself also don't use it. Okay. The other function is Google Map is track where you go to. For example, I have this record before COVID is I went to a few places for business. So I travel they say 9 trips in 92 days. I didn't even know how many days actually I was traveling. So you say 9 trips, 92 days until I open up my file and then I look at, wow, really a lot of places.
So, excuse Mr. Koh, do you need to manually say that I need to track or they automatically track for you or you have to key under safe?
No, it's automatically tracked for you.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you don't have to do anything. You just turn on your mobile phone wherever you are. Like you go to that place because when we travel, right, our phone is always turned on, right? Roaming. So once you roam, it will detect the location. For example, here, it will detect from north to south where I travel, right? From north is Harbin, all the way down to Indonesia, where is this place? Georgia. I went to this southern part of Java and the seaside, very beautiful, it's called Georgia. Yeah. So from a very north place to the south place or even east to west, it will track for you. Even how many places you go in a city, they also track. For example, 2 years ago in Shanghai, I went to 24 places, right? So in Shenzhen, I went 5 places, okay, and so on and so forth. And also they will track for you how many countries that you've been to. For example, on this side, I have been to Indonesia 3 years ago, India 3 years ago, Malaysia 4 years ago, and so on and so forth. They will track wherever you are.
Sorry, Mr. Koh, how do I get to see this screen? Let's say I want to track where I've been before.
I will show you. I'll show you after
that.
Okay,
sure.
Yeah, okay. So now I'm showing you how to use your Google Map to travel from one place to another. So there are a few methods to going to travel from One is using, you can key into the red space here. For example, if you are driving, you can key in a gas station. American, they call gas station, we call petrol station. Or ATM or shopping center or whatever, you just key in. You can key in by name, street name. Okay. Then they will, the moment that you key in like Yishun Street, STR, it will come out, show you which one that you are talking about. So you don't have to key the whole thing, right? For example, here 51, 22, 72, and so on and so forth. The other one is you can key in postal code in Singapore. You can key in postal code, it will show you the place also, right? Or you can key in the building names that you can key in. Right? For example, we say Vivo City, then it will appear the address. Remember just now I tried using the mic. You can see on the left hand side here, there's a mic. You can click on it. Just pick up the location, then it will show you there. Right, it's very good if you are say you're driving, you can't type, but you need to go there. You can just pick it up. But make sure that what you say, your pronunciation got to be accurate. Okay. So if I have not tried my phone in Chinese, so I'm not sure if I key in Chinese, if I speak Chinese, it should record Chinese address. Okay. So far so good, huh?
Yes, thank you.
Okay, don't mention. Welcome. Okay, let's look at the next page. So once we decide where we want to go, for example, Vivo City, and I click location, click direction, then you will ask me where is your starting point. So you just key in your starting point or you key in, remember, your location. So you click your location, you will automatically pick up your location and tell you from your location to Vivo City how long it takes. For example, here, if I drive, 7 minutes. If I ride motorbike, it will be 6 minutes. I'm taking bus or MRT, it will be 30 minutes. If I walk, 36 minutes, and so on and so forth. Right? So here, another box will tell you what time you want to depart. You want to depart at 4 o'clock, and then how long it takes, you will fit here. Right? You can choose, like, I want to go there tomorrow morning, roughly how long it takes. So you can choose other date like today or tomorrow or another date. So it will calculate the time for you. But this calculation don't expect to be very accurate because it's based on the past history. Yeah, past history. So estimated time like 20 minutes, 30 minutes, you can reach the destination. So it's to help you to plan your traveling time so that you won't be late. Yeah, a lot of people will use, traffic jam, this and that. I think it's, if we plan early, we will not be late. Okay. So over here is, for example, if from my location to Vivo City, I have a few buses to take. Okay. Few buses to take, and then how long it go, how long it take to travel to all the places. And it will also give you alternative way or some recommendation. You can choose by bus, by train. Yeah. So for example, if I'm going from Great World City to Vivo City, I will have to take 97, and then after that my next bus will be 65, and I have to travel about 20 minutes. So I have to walk 1 minute to the bus stop, take a bus about 3 stops. They tell you 3 stops, 4 minutes to block 4. Then I need to change to bus 65. So total will take about 20 minutes. Okay. So until here, I'm going to give you a demo on my mobile phone. All right. So I'm going to stop sharing here. By mobile phone, if you have your mobile phone, you can also turn on your phone and then you can start to see. I'm going to share my phone with you. And I'm going to share the Google Map. All right, this is the Google Map. Okay, just now I was sharing with everyone that I want to go to Batu Pahat. So even if you are going out of Singapore, you travel Malaysia, it will work also. Okay. So let us go to the first page. This is the home page of your mobile phone. All right. So there is an explore button. Okay. Okay, when I hit explore, sorry, they will tell you latest in Batu Pahat, what you have in Batu Pahat also. Very smart. They will tell you, you see, some suggestion in Batu Pahat. These are the explore that we will suggest to you where is the place that you can go. And what are the food that you can find. A lot of area that you can go. Then the other one is the go button, the next one. Just now you tell me where I go, right? Yeah, all the places that I went. And then save location. You can save them if you want. Normally I don't. Yeah, just now we're talking about the places that I went, right? The nine trips, 92 days. So you can see the location in the map below, right? I went to Xi'an. Yeah, Xi'an, then you can zoom, see Xiangyang, I went to Xiangyang, I went to Xi'an, I went to Wuhan, this is before COVID, long back. Shanghai, Jiaxing, yeah, then I went to the top, Harbin. Harbin was I went there in March. It's very cold, still very cold that time. Yeah, and then go to Taiwan for holidays. Yeah, and then Indonesia for some business.
You mean those red markers is the places you've been there before, huh?
Yes.
Oh, okay. They mark for you, lah.
They mark the track for you. Okay. So then they will show you the city. You know how many days you stay, like Surakarta, I stayed 13 to 16 in 2018, Xi'an, Xiangyang, you know. All the days, wherever you are, is all tracked.
But if let's say you don't save it, 10 years down the road, will the trip itinerary and all that, will it still be in your Google Map?
I'm not sure because so far it shows me the past 3-4 years.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm on my own, I travel a lot on business. So I've been training for the past 10, 20 years and it doesn't show me all the records. I'm not sure if they keep, I'm not surprised that they keep somewhere in the system. Okay. So Google is very powerful. Yeah.
You let's say you don't want to keep, you don't want people to know, don't want to track. Huh? Is there any way that you default is tracking?
There is a way you can turn off. First, you can turn off the location. The other one is you go inside the history to erase it. I believe I can do that also.
Oh, manually.
Manually, yes. Okay. Manually, you have to delete. Yeah. Okay. Now, let's say we want to go to a place. For example, if I want to go to Bukit Merah Central, now you zoom all the way down. And this is Bukit Merah Center. And if I click on direction, it will show me from my location, you say your location until Bukit Merah Center. Okay, you can see that there's a double arrow, right? I can switch, right? This is-
Sorry, where's the double arrow?
On top. Can you see Bukit Merah and your location? On the right-hand side, there are two arrows up and down.
The two arrows up and down.
Yeah, you can see. I toggle it. You look at the screen. Can you see or not? toggle there on the top. Yeah. Can you see on the top near the battery sign there?
Your location, I see Bukit Merah Central, yes?
Only Bukit Merah Central on the right-hand side.
Oh, you mean up and down the arrow, huh?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
You can toggle in between, right? From your location to go up or from your the other way around.
Or so, to go down, okay.
Yes. So after that, you can press start. Okay, before you start, let me cancel off. Before you start, you may want to choose whether you go by car, by motorbike, by bus, or walking distance.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, cycle is 4 minutes and yeah. So if you walk, they will show you by dot, you know, how you can walk. How you can walk from one location, because right now I'm at block 5. It will show me how to walk from block 5 to Bukit Merah Central. Right? If I take bus, it will take me about 30 minutes. Okay? Then I can take 145, 76, or I can take, take this one. Yeah. Then I say, ask me to walk to block 1, take 76 to Bukit Merah Central, walk, only one stop. Then after that, I have to walk 6 minutes. So there's a lot of things that you can do. For example, you can add to calendar. So if you always using it, yeah. Okay. So that's all for my introduction of Google Map.
Hello, can I ask a question?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, just now you say that if, let's say, I want to meet a friend, I don't know where I am. So from WhatsApp, I can message
that. 我离开了，老师，谢谢。
啊，好的，谢谢，不用客气。
Sorry, can you hear me? Can you do a demo how to send the WhatsApp for my location where I am? I don't even know where I am now, for example. I need to tell myself I'm lost here.
For example, right, for example,
thank you.
I go to WhatsApp, right? WhatsApp. Uh-huh. Then you look for the person that you want to send the data. For example, I have this storage here, and then I put a click. Okay, when you see, you see the clip, right? You see the clip?
Other message, right?
Yeah,
message.
That's a clip.
Okay, solid location. Yeah.
Location.
Okay.
You see location, then it says send your current location.
Oh, what if my location icon is off? Will it work?
No, your location is off, then you cannot send. So you have to send, you have to make sure your location is on.
Oh, okay.
You must have Wi-Fi. No Wi-Fi can do.
Of course.
Sorry, can you show again? Yes, you do so fast. The WhatsApp.
Go to WhatsApp.
Yes.
Find the name that you want to share. For example, I want to share here.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. So I just go to the click.
Where's the click? Sorry, so fast. Where's the click?
Yeah, here. Can you see message? And then there's a paper clip.
Message. Oh, okay. Uh-huh.
You click on the paper clip.
Uh-huh.
You have document, camera, gallery.
Oh, location. Okay.
You just touch location.
Okay.
Send your current location.
Oh, okay.
Okay. So I just hit. Then it will show.
Thank you.
So once you're here, your friend will touch it. Because I have another app, so you will show me a different app. But it's the same. Okay, different app also can bring you to the right place. For example, I use Waze. Waze will show me how to go there. All right. Okay.
Mr. Koh, this lesson, will it be posted onto the Radin Mas Facebook?
Oh, yes. You are live, you know, Facebook live. So whatever you we are talking about today is recorded.
The whole thing, huh?
Yes, yes, yes.
So we can go back to revise. But the problem is this. When I try to look for the past lesson pay now, I can only find 30 minutes of people talking on Zoom. The lesson was not shown.
Hey now, I can't remember. You have to check. May not
check
be
already.
Taught by me. Or may not be taught by me. Yeah, yeah. There's a lot of teacher up there.
I don't know who's the one who do the video recording, but instead of showing the lesson, but I can see 30 minutes of people talking on Zoom, which is not relevant now, because what we want is to revise the lesson. Senior learning things we need to revise. What you tell me now, I can remember. Maybe okay. 4 hours later, I start to fade off. Like, so tomorrow,
yeah,
I want
no
to revise.
Problem.
I have to go back and revise.
Yeah.
So if it's the truncated version, I don't know who do the PNR. I think it's the
live. Sometimes it's the ITE student or what, no? They come and teach, no?
We have poly students. We have poly students teaching also, yes.
Poly students also.
People talking on Zoom is not relevant. I want to, because I just joined only.
Okay, you can go to the silver click. We have a lot of history. You can go in and search for the relevant course that you want to attend. It's all saved in the system. If not, you can ask Redima CC. They have a record on all the dates, so you can go in and check. It's all in the Facebook.
Facebook. The one on pay now is truncated. Just 30 minutes of people talking, but it's not from you lah. I think it's from another organization.
I think it's from another uncle. Also speak bilingual one, I think.
Yeah, but they show 30 minutes of people talking on Zoom is not relevant, man. You know, it's the lesson.
Can I ask a question? Mr. Joshua, can I ask a question regarding the Google Map?
Yes, please.
Okay. In the map, right, just now when you show the transport, for example, Bukit Merah Central, then it will show all the different buses, the number, the time taken, right?
Yeah.
But a lot of time, right, the bus number given, actually not the correct one, in the sense that there are, for example, another bus that has a shorter journey and faster. So how do I Google the correct bus number? Because it's very frustrating. Sometimes ask me to walk 15 minutes to Keppel District Park just to take a bus to connect, you know, from the Keppel all the way down to town or whatever, which is very stupid. I mean, not you. I'm talking about the Google. And also, I realized like 131-272, I'll go to Bukit Merah Central, for example. Okay? Then it will direct me to the wrong bus distance, in the sense that it tells me to take the longer bus journey. So it's very frustrating. How do I go exact to the point, like to get the shorter distance, shorter walking distance?
I hear you. I understand your frustration, because right now you are using the app. The app is actually depending on the signal that take the satellite from the sky. If it is a raining days, the signal is distorted, maybe 50% of accuracy. So whatever you see on your handphone, it will not show you the right direction. Especially when you are in downtown. Let's say you are in city area, Robinson Road, or you are in Marina Bay Sand, Marina area, because there's a lot of tall building and your GPS cannot detect where you are, and they will point you to a wrong place. So that is the reason why you got to go round and round and round. It's not because they are stupid, it's because they can't locate where is your location. The other one is the handphone. There's some setting, how you want to set, whether you want to set it, avoid certain place, like avoid highway, avoid train, avoid harbor, is all there inside. This software is developed by the people. Unfortunately, Singapore is so small that we don't go by ship or go by other thing. But in other country, they find useful. So it is, if the place that we do not know really, we have to Maybe it's the signal is no good, like raining days. You really cannot find you because of the cloud. Yeah, the cloud on the...
Oh.
Yeah, the signal is distorted. Mm-hmm.
This one uses a cloud signal.
Not cloud signal. It's a GPS signal from a handphone to the satellite in the sky.
Oh, I see.
Yeah,
because
satellite.
I Google from home, the direction, like for example, how to go Queen Street, like just now you illustrated.
Yeah.
It will show me to walk 10 to 15 minutes just to catch the next bus. So the time frame is all gone. And the bus, like for example, I can take 124, right? Go People's Park Center. Why tell me? Walk 15 minutes, go to train bus here, train bus there. So
you also not to forget, if you are at home, you are inside under the roof. If you are at home, you are under the roof, the GPS cannot detect where exactly you are. So you may have to go to an open air, like you go downstairs if you are staying in HDB flat. You go downstairs and then you can detect you and say, oh yeah, you should take this. This could be the issue, lah, location issue, because they can't detect you.
Thanks for your insightful answer. No,
I'm just like you. I have been sometimes I drive car, I just go round and round and round, cannot find a location. Very frustrated. It's the same. Everybody has this experience. Yeah.
Excuse me, may I have a suggestion? I have something to share about. Just now there was somebody who asked about bus or this. I use bus lay. Mm-hmm. That one very useful, no? Tell you exactly what bus and how many minutes coming. Whether you're at home or outside. I find this very useful, lah. Wherever you are. So at bus stop, you know the bus stop has got number, right? Code number or someone's block number. So you ask, you download bus lay. This app, very useful.
Yeah.
Oh, thank you.
So today we are only talking about Google Map. There are many apps there to help us. You can download other thing and then you can learn. If you not, you can come to our Redimas, our
thank you, very good.
Here, our SBO, we can teach you.
Yeah, pick up something. Thank you, Mr.
好了吗？ 可以吗？ 大家有没有问题？
没有，学过了。
学会了哦，那个。
Okay,
好的， bye bye. No more question, right?
Next week, what lesson?
Thank you.
next week, I will decide later. I will discuss with Gary, and then we'll see what we're going to teach. Okay.
Thank you, 老师.
Thank you, 谢谢大家，谢谢你们的。